wanted the challenge of being able to play with complex rhythms, work with live music and see how that comes together and find my own narrative and my own sacrifice. Passion, I guess. I mean, yeah. Passion, but I think that in terms of how I work, I start off with improvisation first, you know, and I love complex rhythms, and so I will choose a piece of music and I will start from there, but I always want to create work that starts from the inside out, so it's not normally just about what's happening physically, but it's about what is the feeling, you know, and what am I transmitting out there. So this number one is about, I would say, like connecting to your chakras, so connecting viscerally, because I mean, my flamenco teacher is actually also a yoga, a very big yogi, so she's always talking about the chakras and what different chakras mean. So yeah, when I'm doing that, I'm reacting to what the music are doing, but I'm also just going through my own chakras and acknowledging, you know, there's the sun, there's the heart, and this color is this chakra and whatever, the third eye, so yeah. Look, it took me a very long time to be able to appreciate beach moments. And the reason for that is because I was just terrified, you know. But I think that as I've grown and matured, I think that those are the most powerful moments, actually. Just silence and just being okay with being silence. And yeah, it's hard. I'm still working on it, but I think that it's really important so that everybody breathes as well, you know, because you can't just go. But in my 20s, I didn't care. I was just like, okay, let's go. But now it's like, okay, you also want people to take in that moment and go, okay, there is a focus on a lily, you know, and so what does that mean? My director once said to me when I was very young, is that you have to be able to make people focus on one thing, you know. Yeah, and I think that is incredibly powerful, yeah.